Hi everyone, I'm Guy, and today I'll show you how I made this animation with Cinema 4D and Mixamo. If you haven't heard of Mixamo, it's an amazing motion capture library run by Adobe. It's a free website with tons of assets and it's very user-friendly, so let's get started. After going to Mixamo.com and signing into my Adobe account, in the Characters tab, I'll scroll down and click on the second page and choose the character YBot. You can pick whatever character you'd like, this technique should work with any model. You can even upload your own model to Mixamo using the built-in auto-rigger, but it's beyond the scope of this tutorial. Check out this video to see how it's done. After choosing a model, I'll go over to the Animations tab and search for Belly Dance. I'll be using this option, but you can choose any animation you'd like. I'm going to leave the settings as is, but I encourage you to play around with them. That's how you find the cool stuff. I'll click Download and keep the default settings and hit Download again. Now in Cinema 4D, I'll drag in the FBX file, the default settings are fine so I'll click OK, and we have our model. You can click play to see the animation happening. If you look closely, our model is split into three objects. Alpha joint, it's the joints between our main body parts. You can see it better if I click the solo button, which only shows the selected object. Then we have alpha surface, those are the actual body parts. And lastly we have Mixamo rig hips, this is basically what's driving our animation. It's the bones that control the mesh. We're not going to be touching these in this tutorial, but make sure you don't delete it. If you don't want to see it, you can hold Alt and double click on the little stoplight icon to turn the visibility off. Now before I save this, there's a problem that happens when you import files from Mixamo. If I click on the model and look at the attributes window, you can see that the attributes are locked. I'm not really sure why this happens, and if anyone has a way to disable it, please let me know. A quick fix is to copy the model into a new save file, so I'll select everything, press Ctrl+C to copy. I'll click the plus icon to open a new file, and press Ctrl+V to paste. I'll drag out the timeline to fit the full length of the animation. Cool thing about Mixamo animations is, they loop. So then, I'll click Ctrl+S to save this scene somewhere on my computer. I'll be spamming save many times while I work, I'll remind you to do it too from time to time on screen. Now to make the actual effect. I'm gonna add a cube and set its size to 1 on the X, 7 on the Y and 1 on the Z. Then while pressing Alt, I'm going to add a cloner to the scene. Alt makes the selected object a child of the object you're adding. Then I'm gonna set the cloner's mode to object and in the object field I'm gonna drag in the alpha surface. And if I crank up the count, you can see the cloner is cloning the cube all around our model. Now say you wanted to clone onto the alpha joints too. You might think to create another cloner and set it to the joints mesh, but that's doubling the work you have to do later to tweak the settings, and also leaves room for mistakes. Instead, we should use a connect object. I'm going to select the meshes I want to connect, and while holding Ctrl and Alt, I'll click and hold the generators menu and choose connect. We can go back to the cloner and drag our connect object into the object field. It clones perfectly. But if I click play, you see it has some jittering. The reason for this is because the connect object is trying to weld the two moving meshes together. To fix this, I'll go under the connect object's attributes and turn off weld. Very cool. Now to make this pretty. Time for lighting and rendering. This part will be very beginner oriented, so I'll only be using the built-in physical renderer instead of Redshift or some other renderer to keep things simple. I'll go into the render settings and switch my renderer to physical. In the Output tab, I'll change the resolution to 1000x1000. I'll click on Effect and add Ambient Occlusion. And now if I close the render settings and press Ctrl+R, we can see how this looks. I don't want to see the model anymore, so I'll Alt and double click on the stoplight icons to turn it off. It's looking pretty cool, but we can do better. I'll click and hold the light button to add a spotlight to our scene. If you're not seeing this, you didn't switch the renderer to physical. I'll click E to switch to the move tool and drag it into about where I want it. Then I'll click R and rotate it to our character. I'll zoom in and render and I'll see that the light is affecting our character, but we can't see it. So I'll click the light and in the general tab, I have a field called visible light. I'll change it from none to volumetric. This means the light will collide with objects, whereas in regular visible light, it will pass right through them. I'll click render and see what we got. Pretty cool. I'll make the light yellow-orangey, place my camera wherever I want it, add a plane, press T and click and drag to increase its size. I'll go back to the render settings and in the output tab, I'll change the frame range to all frames or whatever length you want. In the save tab, I'll choose a location and change the file type to MP4. I'll close the render settings and hit save one last time and click render to picture viewer. And that's it! Once this is done, we'll find the rendered scene in the target folder. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like it if you found it helpful and comment if you have any suggestions. Also, I'm going to be making a music video for the song you're hearing right now, and I'm going to share the entire process for free on this channel. So subscribe to stay updated. See you next time. לא יהיה לך שם.